Former Health Secretary Janette Garin welcomes the probe on the alleged anomaly surrounding the 8.1 billion peso barangay health station project. But she appeals to Health Secretary Francisco Duque III to hear her side on the matter. Aiko Miguel tells us why.
Former Health Secretary Janette Garin supports the plan of the Department of Health to file lawsuits relating to the alleged anomaly in the barangay health station project of the agency. Garin says she is willing to face probe, but she appeals to Health Secretary Francisco Duque III to hear her side on the said irregularities in the procurement process.
So bottom line here is, there is no perfect program, but there will always be solution, lalo na pag sa inuupuan, tinitingnan yung problema at hinahanapan ng sagot. But if there are violations, then I agree, head should roll. If there is corruption, head should also roll. Pero huwag naman po sana ng agad-agad na nagbihintang.
She also insists she only implemented the program and that she took some measures then to address the issue.
Kung meron na mga problema sa implementation, ganun din po ang inaputan ko sa DOH nung ako'y pumasok. Pero ang ginawa ko po, pinapatawag ko yung mga directors involved, tinitingnan kung ano yung problema.
Garin maintains she is innocent and that she is ready to present documents that will disprove the alleged anomaly in the project. The Barangay Health Station was launched during the Aquino administration when Garin was still the DOH secretary. Meanwhile, Garin's successor, former Health Secretary Pulino Bial, said in a statement that she also found some problems in the health station project during her time. She adds she reported it to the Commission on Audit last February 2017. Malacanang, meanwhile, expects Secretary Duque to submit necessary evidences and file charges against those involved.
Pwede po yan kung ang kakasuhan ay triable before the Sandigan Bayan. Kinakailangan po i-forward ni Secretary Duque sa Ombudsman ang kanyang makakalap na mga dokumento at iba pang ebidensya.
Aiko Miguel, UNTV News and Rescue, Quezon City.